Hello! Welcome back to the Wrestling Newsroom. I'm your host, All Things Wrestling, and today we're going to be looking at all the wrestling news from Friday. We start with some new details around the Bray Wyatt car accident. TMZ reports that Bray Wyatt was determined to be at fault in the car accident that took place on Friday. The crash report states that Wyatt wasn't paying attention to traffic when he crashed into the vehicle in front of him. That vehicle ended up veering to the left and hitting a third vehicle. Wyatt was cited for careless driving due to his failure to operate his vehicle in a careful and prudent manner. Absolutely horrible situation. I am most thankful, though, that no one was seriously hurt or killed in this situation. I'm hoping Bray Wyatt learns from this and learns that you need to pay attention when you're behind the wheel of a car. And I'm just hoping a swift and speedy recovery for everybody involved in this horrible car accident. Then Mike Johnson was talking about why there was low TV viewership for Pop TV with Impact Wrestling. He said, "I've heard from multiple people," and when I say multiple people, I mean like five or six people, who are like, "Why do you think our numbers are still dropping?" One of those things, they're pointing fingers at the amount of content they're putting on YouTube, because their digital numbers are doing very well right now. There is a feeling that they are putting everything on YouTube, so no one is watching the TV show, and the TV is more important than the YouTube. Completely agree, but people like digital stuff. And then, on the latest edition of WWE Ride Along, Rusev explains why he was initially pulled from the Greatest Royal Rumble casting match. Rusev went, "Remember when Vince saw me, I'm going to face Undertaker," and I laughed at him. And English said, "You just laughed at the chairman's face for one of the biggest matches of your career. And what did I get for it? I got pulled out." Then the Saudi prince called. Tutu. He's like, "You told me Rusev Day is going to be coming to town, baby." So, that is the story. Vince is like, "You're facing the Undertaker." And Rusev's like, And Saudi prince is like, "Yo, we got Rusev Day, baby." Yeah, that was a funny story, and I'm just going to cringe at how I did that. Let's move on swiftly. Then we've got a bit of an injury update for WWE Superstars. Nakamura is not officially been cleared yet. He is reportedly scheduled to be evaluated July 9th. Bray Wyatt is scheduled to be evaluated today, July 6th. Ruby Riott is scheduled to be evaluated July 30th, but she isn't expected to miss much time with her ACL sprain. Dave Meltzer also noted the injury to Sami Zayn's right shoulder actually took place back in August at a live event in Montreal against Jinder Mahal. Zayn has been working with the injury since that time through Money in the Bank. Damn. What a trooper. Then we go to kind of a murky situation. Former Ring of Honor star Taylor Hendricks wrote the following on Twitter in response to a fan stating he missed the faction House of Truth. She went, "I don't. It should have been House of Hendricks. What has Truth or Jay done? What do they draw? Being a funny guy with a book. The other only talks about his time in Impact copying legends. Fiori or brother, the legacy is copying legends." And then a fan responded saying, Jay is now a two-time Ring of Honor world champion, longest reigning Ring of Honor television champion, only man in history of Ring of Honor to become undisputed Ring of Honor champion, world, and TV at the same time. No offense to you or anything, but what have you done lately? Fair point, but this is where it gets murky. Also, the dude you're standing up for is the same dude that told me because I didn't sleep with him, they sabotaged me and took me off TV. That being the almighty Jay. She then followed up with, "Silence's acceptance that allows a corrupt system to divide and conquer. I don't accept that anymore. Silence is deafening and acceptance is blinding. We deserve better. I know this is going to be on wrestling sites. My name is Taylor and this is my statement. Attorneys on my behalf have an ongoing investigation. I know I'm not the only one, and people that have known this investigation have been supportive. I'll continue to fight for what's right." Then we have a bit of update. Kind of. She then said, "Let the hate roll in. Doesn't change what happened. I came forward privately long ago and now it's public. When I stay silent, I'll be part of the problem. I can't live with that. I'll fight for what's right. Threatening me support supposed burned bridges changes nothing. Let the hate roll in. And why Jay Lethal hasn't yet made a public comment on the matter. He did like the tweet from the following tweet from Sanjay Dutt saying, slander, fucking insane, batshit insane. Oh, sorry, batshit crazy. So I assume that's kind of a response to it. There's been no proper updates, no actual confirmation. There is a lawsuit going on at this time, but it's a murky situation, to be honest. If Jay Lethal did that, then God, I have lost a lot of respect for the guy. If he didn't do that, I've got no respect for her. That's a her. Yeah, a her. Yeah. We'll just have to wait and see. I don't know which way he's going to go, but it's going to show no straight down the middle and just report what's going on with it for now. I'll give you an update as soon as I have one. And then, according to the Twitter account Heal by Nature, WWE has applied for new trademarks, which are Top Rope and Dr. Shelby. It appears that WWE is looking to do a clothing line with Top Rope based on the filing information. So we could be getting new Shelby stuff. That'd be cool. I like Dr. Shelby. And then we go to Goldberg saying he's open to facing Reigns. All I gotta say is it ain't up to me. Whether it's Reigns or Taker, and I don't know. I'm not gonna say anybody else, hey, Reigns and Taker are two guys on my list right now. I mean, obviously for two different reasons, but I'd be honoured to get in the ring with either one of them. Fair point. I could see Goldberg Reigns match happening. And then WWE announced that NXT superstar Oney Lorcan will be missing around about 3 months of action due to a broken orbital bone. He suffered the injury while in his match in NXT TakeOver Chicago 2 with Danny Burch against the Undisputed Era. Damn it. And they did so good as well. And then Bret Hart recently did an interview in the In Your Corner podcast and talked about Owen Hart and the Hall of Fame. He said Owen was the nicest, kindest, most adorable wrestler. For his kindness, like, he's not remembered for his high-flying. He may be remembered for his pranks, jokes, but more importantly, he's remembered for the kind of guy he was and being a real friend to people when they were struggling or got depressed or were bummed out about being away from their homes all the time. Owen was one of those kind of guys where it was almost like magic, where he could pick up your spirits and make you smile to get through the day. There's a lot of great wrestlers who haven't got their pat on the back at the Hall of Fame and it started bothering me to the point where I don't think I will go again to any of these ceremonies until they put in proper deserving candidates. And Owen's widow, Martha. Oh yeah, I think Martha Owen's widow. So I think Martha Owen's widow is very obtuse, square-headed person. I think she's done more to erase my brother Owen's memory than she ever did to remember him. I think it really bothered me that fans that loved Owen so much don't get a chance to remember him. You do these kind of things for people that are here left to remember them. So he wants to see Owen in, by the sound of that, and it sounds like Martha's the reason he's not getting in. Just let him in. I want to see Owen Hart in the Hall of Fame. He was fantastic. He really was. Hopefully one day he'll get his dues. Then we go to the news that Donna Perez announced that she'll no longer be participating in the All In event in September 1st. This has led to speculation that she'll be part of WWE's upcoming Mae Young Classic. Cody Rhodes responded to Perez with the comment that some fans believe was referring to Triple H. He went, take one large step forward in the photo. He likes to make people look shorter than him. Good luck, D. Beat everyone. Run up the score. Quite entertaining. And then we now have a couple more all-in stories. Impact stars Christopher Daniels and Frankie Kazarian have been announced for all-in. And then the big match has been set. Okada versus Marty Scurll. Yes, Okada and Scurll are going to clash at All In. That
sounds so good. That seriously sounds so good.
Then guitar maker Fender has established a working relationship with Elias. That's pretty damn cool. I like the fact that he's actually got a person with him now. And then a losing streak has been ended. Oh yes, I'm here to report. The losing streak of the century has been ended. The Ascension has ended a 2-year losing streak. Sorry, it's not Kurt Hawkins. I know, yeah, that's what you thought. Yeah, they defeated Heath Slater and Rhino in this week's Men Event tapings. They had a 163 losing streak, with their last win being over Damian Sandow and Fandango on February the 8th, 2016, taping of WWE Superstars. Jesus Christ, that's a hell of a losing streak. And then there is... we'll go with this one first. Oh, latest on Jason Jordan. He's back on the road with WWE. He was in Seattle representing WWE in the 2018 Special Olympics USA Games. He's expected to be back on WWE television once the creative team have a storyline for him. Then we go to the belief that Rey Mysterio signed a 2-year deal with WWE. Heel by Nature did say not a credible source. They were regurgitating bullshit stories from Dirt Sheet and disguising them as exclusives. The only other person, well, the other credible source to debunk this was Dave Meltzer, who just stated false as a few hours ago, but could happen soon. So two credible sources have denied he has signed a contract, so probably not. And then WrestleVotes has a very interesting update on Daniel Bryan's contract. Regarding Daniel Bryan's contract, WWE has a strong idea of what he's going to do, so much so that months ago the decision was made to have him to have the WWE 2K19 showcase mode. I don't remember last year having a showcase mode. Revolve around him. Having that game released without Bryan on the roster wouldn't look good. So, yeah, the speculation is he signed a new contract. Or he will be signing a new contract. Let's hope. And then let's just run down the Impact Wrestling's anniversary card quickly for July 22nd. Austin Aries Moose for the Impact World Championship. Su Yung versus Madison Rayne Knockouts Championship. Matt Sydal, Brian Cage X Division Championship. House of Hardcore match Eddie Edwards, Tommy Dreamer. Hair versus Mask, Pentagon Jr. versus Sami Callihan. Johnny Impact versus Ishimori versus Phoenix versus Rich One. Yeah, I'm hyped for this one. This looks like it's going to be good. It seriously does. And that is all the news I have to report today. I'm going to try and get back into these more regularly, seriously. Especially when I'm on holiday. Kind of just keep you up to date so you can at least comment on a video. But yeah, That's all it is. Thank you for watching. As always, if you have enjoyed this video, please give it a like. Please support me on Patreon. Link in the description below. Subscribe to more content, and I'll catch you later. Bye.